14 ounces and moves to the 29th place currently. Unfortunately going to fall outside of the cut, but first classic. After coming here once, how bad do you want to get back here and get another shot at it?
You know, I'm definitely thinking I'm going to be back. This is my first one, but I bet it's not my last. I've had absolutely a great time. Definitely a memory I'll never forget. Just being around all these great guys, all of them are class acts. Just being around them, fishing with them, and getting to talk to them in the hotel, it's been a wonderful time. And I'd like to thank all my friends and family for being here. Look at this crowd. This crowd's awesome. Stadium full of people. Love being down here in Texas. It's just it's an awesome feeling. I'd also like to thank my sponsors for letting me be here. If it wasn't for everybody supporting me, there's no way I'd be here.
Well, I look forward to seeing you back here. You've done a great job representing. What's ahead of you for the rest of the year as part of the Carhartt College Bass program?
I got a few opens left this year. Try to win one of those, get back in next year.
Go get it done. I know you can. Let's hear it for John Garrett, ladies and gentlemen.
Way to go, buddy. Thanks a lot. The next angler coming in, Houston, Gonzalez, Louisiana. Here comes Ryan Lappy.
The scene of the crime after having 16 pounds, 10 ounces yesterday. And Ryan Levine bringing us a limit here today. Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get it inside that cut. 13 pounds, 3 ounces, gives him 29-13. And Ryan Levine is well within the cut in fourth place currently. Well, you know, some people like to take a day off, but the Bassmaster class, you don't want to take any days off, and you're not gonna. It looks like you're gonna be back out there tomorrow with a shot at this title. Man, I sure hope so. I think it's gonna be close. I left a few out there today, but it's the Bassmaster's classic, you know, you gotta execute. We had fun though, man. I changed something up at noon, made a decision, and it worked. So if I get to go tomorrow, I'm hoping I can have a little bit of fun doing that. We're going to do everything totally different. So we'll see what happens. I'm looking forward to seeing it. But I got to ask you, after winning the Bass Nation Championship on Conroe by over 16 pounds, then rolling in here, if you were to take this title, I got to believe you got to move to Conroe. I mean, it's done enough for you. You got to buy a vacation home or something.
It's funny you say that, because today, my marshal said, man, I like that house up there on the bank with all that yard. I said, I trolled by that thing the other day looking for bedding fish that I never found. And I saw the for sale sign on it, and I said, well, if I win this thing, I gotta buy that house.
He's already got the house picked. Go get the bank five fish. And all you gotta do is
come. Next thing is from Maiden, North Carolina. How about some noise here for Hank Cherry?
Bassmaster Classic qualifier and two-time Bassmaster winner, a former Toyota Trucks All-Star Champion.
Digging deep in that Triton Mercury live well.
Had 7 pounds, 15 ounces yesterday, and unfortunately, another tough day here today. Two fish here today, 7:15 yesterday, two fish to add to that here today. 5 pounds and 9 ounces, gonna move into 30th place with 13 pounds, 8 ounces, and the trek begins again to get back here.
Well, you know, the trek already started, and I'm off to a great start this year. But the other day, I popped, jerk, drag, hop, buzz, skid, did everything I could not figure out what was going on. I think our official practice really screwed me. I got out there and I found some fish that were postponed that I moved up that hadn't been there, had a great day throwing jerk bait, catch them off little drops, and I had it in my head, look, you're gonna do this the whole time, you're gonna hammer. Didn't work out there. I pulled into a marina today, had nobody in there, and I literally, for hours on hand, fished. You know, I caught 10, 11 at Chickamauga a couple years ago. I fished for the biggest fish I've ever seen in my life. I mean, this is like something you would have seen Jeremy Wade fishing for on river monster. It was huge. And I just could not get the sucker to commit. And that was just, you know, this part of it. Confidence sometimes ruins your tournament. And I was very confident, stuck in what I was going to do. And I basically did what Van Dam always says not to do. I fished where they were, not where they were going. So, you know, it's a great time. This is an awesome crowd. This is the perfect turnout for this thing. I want y'all to cheer these guys on. You got more fish coming, I promise. But I did catch a limit. I had to go today, Tuesday, so. I want to thank all my family, they're right there in the red, for coming to see me. That's my support crew, you know, without them I wouldn't have got here. And, you know, I heard a long time ago, I guess it was about 6 or 7 years ago, a guy told me, you know, sometimes you've got to stop doing what you're doing and start doing what you're meant to do. And, you know, for me that happened 5 years ago. Bass came to this platform to be able to chase fish. You know, I'm just living a childhood dream, you know. I never would have dreamed that. I always thought that window had passed for me, but I'm here to prove to you, you're never too old if you want to get in this game, because I'm a lot older than I look, but I feel young. My back hurts. And let me tell you one more thing I learned about Connor. There are no wake zones. Those are mow wake zones. When them big suckers, big boats see those things, they just plow on by and make big waves. But I want to thank all my sponsors. I'm not going to go through a list, but everybody, you're the reason why I can come and do this. I appreciate you guys for all coming out. Enjoy the rest of the weekend.
Always great to have you here.
All right, man, thanks a bunch. Gonna bring our next guy. Well, he's another angler from Gonzales, Louisiana. Here comes Greg Hector.
The Hack Attack in 2014, Charter Bassmaster Angler of the Year. A 5-time Bassmaster winner and a former Ford Wood become the champion. At 13 pounds and 6 ounces, and promised to sell Iaconelli the trophy. At 13.6 yesterday.
Yes, for the way home.
13.6 yesterday, two fish to add to it. 5.9. 18 pounds, 15 ounces, and it doesn't mean you're not going to sell him the trophy. I mean, it's just unfortunately not this trophy, but you'll be back.
They'll make another one. I'm sure they will. But, yeah, I don't know. You know, these things a little bit, but just sometimes it happens, you know. But the cool thing about it is I'm going to be able to spend tomorrow doing my second favorite thing on Sunday. I'll be at the Expo. I'll be somewhere between the Garmin booth, the Phoenix booth, the Mercury booth, somewhere, but I'll be busy at the Expo. You know, I love that on Sundays.
You love the Expo. Hey, who's going to go see Greg Hackney at the Expo tomorrow?
Come early.
Come early. And just so you know, he's a hugger, so hug him.
But, you know, it's a great lake. And you know, honestly, this is one of the classics. I've been around them. I actually got to watch a guy catch them this morning, so I know I've been around them, but for some reason it just didn't work out, but hopefully I'll be back.
I'm pretty sure you'll be back, my friend, one of the most lethal anglers on tour.
Greg, next guy coming in, he's from Grand, Alabama. How about a little love here from Texas?
Another member of the Carhartt College Bass Program, a former Carhartt College Bass Champion, now makes his living on the Bassmaster Elite Series and represents Carhartt all year long.
We're sure happy you're out here. Let's hear it for Jason Christie.
All right, Jason, let it go. We've got another guy from just north of us here from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Coming in, how about it for James Keelan?
Fishing is second. Geico Bassmaster Classic. Fished his first one in front of his hometown crowd of Tulsa, Oklahoma. But started off this one with a bang, 20 pounds and an ounce yesterday. Looking to back it up here today. And he may just have done that. Yesterday with just four fish yesterday. He's got a limit today. 20 pounds an ounce yesterday. To add to that, needs 17 pounds, 12 ounces. A brand new Geico daily leader, James Keelan. The lead right now, that fish right there, 5 pounds, 12 ounces, and boy, you are going fishing on Championship Sunday at the Bassmaster Classic.
I am. It's been a long time since I've felt the feeling I felt today. You know, you just get, there's something that you really look forward to in bass fishing, you know, once you start doing this, and there's just very few tournaments where you really have a good one, and things start working, you start to see the light, and it's one of those days today, and I don't know if there's any left, but I know what I'm going to go do tomorrow, and I'm going to put the throttle down as hard as I can. I think I wasted a little bit of time this morning doing all this stuff, so finally got the right deal again, and shoot, man, it's fun when you're catching them.
It is a lot of fun, five fish away from a lifelong dream. How long have you been dreaming of hoisting that trophy?
Oh, it's been a long time. Probably since I can't remember, you know, really, really young. So it's something every kid thinks about. You know, I grew up fishing, and that's the first thing, that's what you look up to. So, yeah, I hope to be in the hunt for it anyways.
You're in the hunt right now. Let's hear it for James Hill.
All right, we'll go, James. Hey, I bet you there's somebody in the house that'll give this guy a war eagle when he comes in. He's Marvin, Alabama. How about it for Steve Kennedy?
Champion of professional bass fishing, a two-time Elite Series champion, had 17 pounds and 7 ounces yesterday, and looking to keep that drive to Championship Sunday going here today. With freak nasties just like that. 17-7 yesterday. Now by the looks of things, he's locked and loaded here on day number two with his eyes on the ultimate prize, Championship Sunday, for the Geico Bassmaster Classic. Steve Kennedy, 17 pounds, 7 ounces yesterday. Needs 20 pounds, 7 ounces to take the lead. Just four fish today. 15 pounds, 11 ounces. He moves into third place with 33 pounds and 2 ounces. Weigh that for Berkeley Big Bass. 6 pounds, 5 ounces, not going to take over Berkeley Big Bass, but 33 pounds, 2 ounces, and you guys always say the same thing. I just want to go into Sunday with a shot, and you've definitely done that.
Yes, definitely. But yeah, I feel better today about 4 fish than I did about 5 yesterday. I lost a couple of big fish yesterday. Today I only had 4 keeper bites that I know of, and I put them all in the boat, and had them all by 9 o'clock, and, you know, I can't say I've had a keeper bite since. So, all my big bites come doing the same thing, and I kept doing it even when the wind wasn't blowing. It was probably a mistake. I probably could have slowed down and caught another fish or two, but we're trying to win. That's why we're here. So, what I had to do, and I'm going to go do it again tomorrow.
I can't wait to see how it works out.
All right. You can see our next anchor coming in from North Prince George, Virginia. Give it up for Jacob Perbrosnick.
On the Bassmaster Elite Series.
Jacob Brosnick is definitely one of the most lethal Elite Series assassins on tour.
Coast to coast, you gotta watch this guy no matter where we go. At 14 pounds and 9 ounces yesterday. Oh, we're not gonna fall for that. Jacob Brosnick bringing us a limit of fish. Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen. Pounds and 9 ounces yesterday. 5 fish to add to that here today. 13 pounds even gives you 27 pounds and 9 ounces. And I've got to ask the question that is burning in the bass fishing industry. Are those shorts pink or salmon?
I don't know. I'll let y'all be the judge of that. But man, I'm just going to tell you right now that good things are going to come tomorrow. I promise you something. One of the top 25 is getting ready to weigh in over a 30-pound bag. Yeah, I've been bass fishing a long time, and like I'm nervous. I've never seen anything that what happened this afternoon. I'm just gonna leave it at that. But I mean, what a crowd! What a great place to fish. Conroe has got some unbelievable bass, and I'm just letting you know. I mean, things could get broken tomorrow.
It is. We already know. I mean, the giant Toyota share lunkers that have come from there. If we've ever set up a classic to have somebody to make a giant championship Sunday charge, besides when Evers make up a 6-pound difference last year, it could be even bigger this year.
Absolutely. I get to wear the best sunglasses in the world. That's Costa. And if you can only imagine what I've looked through them Costa sunglasses today, my knees are shaking right now. I'm just telling you. If they stay there and hang around, I promise you I'll have something for y'all to scream about tomorrow.
How big are we talking?
I'm going to say 35 plus.
Let me hear it for Jacob Perosnick.
Ooh, yeah. All right. Got another Alabama anchor coming in from Gunnersville. Give it up for Randy Howell.
Ladies and gentlemen, please get up on your feet and give it up for Randy Howell.
The 2014 Geico Bassmaster Classic Champion, everybody howl for Randy Howell! At 4 pounds, 8 ounces yesterday, we had to get our bass out of the light there. Pounds 8 ounces yesterday. Two fish to add to that here today. Looking for 11 pounds 8 ounces to get inside the cut currently. 8 pounds 6 ounces. But let's hold up that big one more time. 12 pounds 14 ounces. Unfortunately, going to call it in. The Randy Howell Geico Bassmaster Classic. Randy, not going to get that chance to make that giant charge tomorrow, but I know that fish right there must have been a welcome addition.
Yeah, I caught that one first thing this morning. I thought, man, I'm getting ready to have one of them miracle days. And then it just kind of nothing happened after that. That's been the thing this week. I never really figured out what to do yet. That's the way it goes sometimes. You know, it's always somebody's got to lose. Somebody's got to win. It's a lot more fun to win
because you learn a lot more when you lose. So I've learned a lot this week. If we ever come back here, I've got revenge to get on this leg. But I'm glad I'll be getting to work with all you guys out there tomorrow at the expo. So y'all get to come see us. We're going to be at the Livingston Lures booth. We're going to be at Triton booth, Mercury booth, Lowrance booth, Pelican. Who else? Iowa. We got new rod reels. Got coffee cups. Got phone cases to show. Got baits to show. We got everything to show. King's Home selling tickets for my boat to give away. Man, we got it all. Got scales, clothing, my new shirt, the scales shorts. Man, I got everything. What else can we talk about? Did I get it all in there?
I think you got it all. I think you hit every single one of them. And who's gonna go see Randy Howe at the expo tomorrow?
Yeah, it's gonna be fun. Like Jacob was just saying, tomorrow will be a fun weigh-in. It's really cool to fish a classic on a lake like this, just like at Gunnersville that year, where anybody can come from behind and win in a big event like this. And that's what everybody comes for, is to see drama. And that's what we're going to be seeing tomorrow. So y'all make sure you come tomorrow. Don't just watch it live. Come in person and see it, because it's different when you're sitting here watching it. So y'all come see it.
I'm looking forward to it.
All right, let's bring our next angler in. Comes to us from Daneville, Missouri. How about it, everybody, for Scott Cliff.
There qualified for his first and classic. Unfortunately, yesterday did not register a fish, but he's got him today. Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Cliff. Two fish here today for Scott Cliff. And I know you are happy to bring them across this stage. Let's get you on over here. Two fish today, 6 pounds and 6 ounces. Hold them high. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it. Let's welcome him to his very first Geico Bassmaster Classic. Not the finish you were hoping to have out of here in your first classic, but boy, must feel good to hold up those fish on this stage.
Very good. You know, I shanked it out there. I just didn't fish well.
Okay.
But I thought about it on the way in. There's a lot of ways to make record books for the Bassmaster Classic. But I don't think two juicer is the way to do it. You don't want to be that guy. So I'm glad to have
it. It's great to have you here. And how bad is the drive to want to get back here?
It's what I'm going to work for forever until you find a path back. This is... Anybody that bass fishes, there is nowhere they would rather be than right here.
It's great to have you here. We look forward to seeing you back here again.
Thank you. I would like to thank some people. Phoenix Boats and Mercury Motors have been huge for me. And Lou's, best reels they make. It is SRC and Clearcast Marine Electronics have helped me a lot. Dave with Baitmasters and Aldridge. I just want to give a special shout out to him. I hope he's watching at home, because it means a lot to me. And Powerful. And if you'll allow me, my son, I've been at Williams for my whole life. And he said, Dad, you never say my name. You're going to be on ESPN. So Briar Cliff, thank you, buddy.
We're going to make it up to him right now. But what was his name again?
Briar Cliff.
Okay, everybody, in the count of three, you may have missed him, but we're going to get several thousand people to say it right now. Briar Cliff is what I want you to say. One, two, three. Briar Cliff! You just paid him back for years.
That's awesome. Way to go. All right, next lane, you're coming in from Lakeland, Florida. How about it, everybody? Let's give it up for Bobby Lane.
Big fish Bobby Lane got that nickname in the Toyota Texas Bass Classic. At the inaugural TTBC, he rolled home out of town with a brand new Toyota Tundra for winning big bass there. Had 16 pounds, 8 ounces yesterday. Four fish to add to that here today. Currently sitting in 24th place. Yeah. yesterday in four fish for Bobby Lane here today. Let's get him inside that cup. He's there right now, but let's get him some pads so he can stay there all the way to Championship Sunday. 11 pounds and 5 ounces with 27 pounds and 3 ounces. Bobby Lane moves into 8th place currently.
If I followed Jacob Borosnik, I'd say we could split him and probably make up the difference by the sounds of what he said up here. But, you know, I just not quite on the right quality fish right now. You know, I mean, it was an absolute grind today to scrap up what I did. But I'm fishing the classic. I mean, it doesn't get much more exciting than that.
Definitely does not. Tomorrow, no points, nothing on the line. Will you change everything, or is there an adjustment bait-wise you can make to just target those big fish?
Shiners?
Trip?
Okay, just go out there and fish the way I know how to fish. I mean, I'm doing exactly what I love to do. I'm flipping braid in bushes with Steve Reese's Pit Boss. I'm running way up the river, so June bug's the magic color. It just seems like that darker color's the deal. Man, getting up there this morning, it was a joy, actually, compared to yesterday, because the wind was howling, and then you got all excited, and, about my second cast, I lose a 5-pounder, and I'm like, well, they're biting at least, and after about 3 hours, I realized they weren't biting, but, maybe without so much boat pressure and stuff like that, I can get up there and have fun. It's just been a great week. I mean, I'm rigged with the best equipment, my Phoenix, my Yamaha. I mean, I've had 3 marshals even during our Wednesday practice, and every one of them said how wonderful that boat motor is. And of course, power poles are huge. Yesterday in the wind, half the fish I caught was because I could drop my power poles and utilize the area I was in. I'm running the new Ray Marines this year, and wow, have they been a joy on my boat and made it a lot easier for me to catch more fish. So I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Hopefully the next 17 guys left don't have more than I got, and I get a shot at it, because I really don't want to go to the fun zone, but if I make it there, I'll be more than happy to be there.
All right, well, we'll keep our fingers crossed for you. I think you're going to be here.
Nick, thanks for coming in. Had a pretty good day yesterday, I'd say. Let's see what he does today at the Newport Beach, California. Give it up for Brent Ehler.
The entire tournament, your day one Geico daily leader here at the Geico Bassmaster Classic, and looking to back it up here on day number 2 at 23 pounds and 3 ounces yesterday, and it looks like he's going digging right now. Houston, get loud. Bite has been the difference maker on day one, and another big one here today. Looking for 14 pounds and 11 ounces to take the lead. 5 fish. 20 pounds and an ounce. To 43 pounds and 4 ounces. We have a brand new Geico daily leader. A brand new leader, and the train is rolling for 2 days in a row. And 4 ounces, an incredible tournament, and so incredible that you made the train roll. You made the train roll. I mean, and that got to be the goal tomorrow. I mean, if you pull this off, we may figure out a way to get you to go up there and ride the train with your trophy.
Man, if I could win this thing, I'd climb tooth and nail to get up there and jump on top of that and ride around here. So it's such a great tournament. It's an amazing crowd out here right now, and I'm really nervous. I
you know, I haven't been in contention in about 2 years. And you really have to put yourself in a position to win. And I kind of feel it right now. I really do. I think there's a chance. And, you know, it's a grind. But I think I really have a great opportunity. I really do. And we'll see what happens.
It is going to be a spectacular championship Sunday. We talked about it this morning. Your first classic last year. I mean, you've won just about everything there is outside of Bass, and you came to that classic thinking, another big tournament, I'm excited. You rolled up to Takeoff, and that all changed. How are you going to keep that out of your head tomorrow?
You know, it'll be tough. It's, you know, such a big event that your emotions are up and down constantly, all day. You know, it's not, you don't go through, you know, kind of an excitement in the morning and then dull. I mean, it's, you're up, you're down, you're all over the place. And keeping a level head is going to be the key, and I think I can do it tomorrow. And, you know, if I just put my head down and grind it out, I have a legitimate chance of winning this thing.
Who wants to see Brad Adler close the deal tomorrow? An incredible tournament at this point.
All right, going to be a shootout, that's for sure. Coming up next, our anchor from New Plymouth, Idaho. How about it for Daryl Okamika?
Yesterday, today, 6 pounds, 7 ounces, and fall outside of the cut with 15-10. Well, let's hear it, because you are officially a Geico Bassmaster Classic qualifier. Unfortunately, I'm not going to get a chance to get back out there on Championship Sunday, but dude, you're a Bassmaster Classic qualifier, and keep catching them on the Elite Series. We might see you back here next year.
Yes, sir. That's the goal for this year. Is next year they go to Hartwell, so I want to see what Hartwell's all about. I had them buttoned today. I have the bites. I probably would have 15, 16 pounds if I had kept them buttoned up, but for whatever reason, they were feisty today. They were really feisty. Didn't want to cooperate so well with me, but hey, for everybody out there that's a nation guy, nation gal, whomever, I'm living proof of what you can achieve. Go out, fish your state qualifiers, fish your divisionals, get to the nation championship. Look where you could be standing in no time. This experience is absolutely awesome. Look at you guys, holy cow. If I get to come here and do this again, man, I can't even tell you how much fun it'd be. I'm gonna work my butt off this year, try and get to Hartwell next year, and you know, the nation program, like you were saying, I got a Phoenix boat. You know, they do an awesome program. Phoenix is back to nation big time. You know, you guys just get out, work hard. You know, I need to thank a few people. First off, the big group right there holding the white signs, that's my family. They came all the way from Idaho to support me. Thank you guys. I love you guys more than you understand. Shimano, Loomis. Shoot, I got so many people that I'm so damn nervous, I don't even know what to do. Have a good day. I'll see you guys at the expo tomorrow. If you see me, stop me. Autographs, pictures, I don't really care. If you want to talk, I'm game. Thanks.
We'll see you there.
All right. And that show's going to be great as usual over here tomorrow. Hey, where? Nick Fingers coming in out of Lancaster, Kentucky. How about it, everybody, for Brett Leroy.
With 22 pounds and an ounce, here is very first Geico Bassmaster Classic. He's the youngest angler ever to fish the Bassmaster Elite Series. see what happened on day two. Bradley Roy gets it done. Looking for 21-4 to take the lead. 15 pounds and 9 ounces with 37 pounds and 10 ounces. Bradley Roy moves into third place. Sitting in third place in your very first classic, going to be going out with a very legitimate chance to become a Bassmaster Classic champion. Tell me what that feels like.
Man, I can't even explain how awesome it is. You know, today was a lot tougher on me. I hope some of you guys are watching me on Bassmaster Live. And I stuck to my guns. I stayed with my game plan, and it took me all day to catch those five. I caught that last one was about 30 minutes to go that biggest one, but I don't know. All you can do is ask for a chance in the last day. I'm going to sleep on it tonight, maybe change my game plan up, but you know what? I'm so blessed to be here. God's great. He gave me a great season last year. To be here standing on this stage is something I've dreamed about. I got awesome family, friends, girlfriend giving support to me. They're all screaming. That's so cool. But, you know, I fish from the best platform. I try that mercury on the back of it gets me where I need to go. So I don't know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I don't even know what a classic would mean to me. That thought in my head. I've got to figure out a way to get some more bites. Brent's obviously set the bar pretty high, but you know what? I saw a day in practice where I caught over 25 pounds, so if I can get that to happen again, we might be having fun about this story.
Look out. Looking forward to seeing how it works out. I wish you luck and see you back here tomorrow.
Here you go, VR. Next angler up is from Spring City, Tennessee, Wesley Strader.
Bassmaster Classic. A win at the Bass Pro Shops, the Bassmaster Holdings last season. At 19 pounds and 9 ounces yesterday. And digging deep in that live well. The thrill of victory and the agony of angling. From hero to zero, 19 pounds and 9 ounces. And unfortunately, a goose egg here today. I'll try to sugarcoat it a little bit. You're not the only one.
Nah, there's no sugarcoat. It's I had a few opportunities today where I could do a little bit better. On the way in, I kept thinking, you know, what am I going to say? I just zeroed the day two of Bassmaster Classic. But what I'm going to say is the Bassmaster Classic. So, I got to thank a few people while I'm up here because I ain't got no fish to weigh in. So, I got to thank Hell's Construction. I wouldn't be here without them. I got to thank Ranger, Evergreen, Power Poles. This week I've caught all my fish on two baits. I caught them on a Bangle Flame Spinnerbait and Zorro and a Fishhead Primal Spin. And both of those are available at Dick's Sporting Goods. I have run that mercury all over the place. I was on a shad spawn deal. And you know, first thing in the morning I catch a couple, and then I go out deeper and I was fishing deep brush piles for the spinnerbait. And for some reason today, you know, I had one great big one hooked, and I was having to go to a smaller line to keep a smaller spinnerbait down. It got me down the brush, drove me off. And I lost another one, probably about 4 pounds, but those are the only two opportunities I had today. And I told myself, I said, I can make the cut, or I can go try to win this thing. And I stuck to my guns and I tried to win it, because you can't win just making the cut. You got to be up there close. You got to be within shooting distance of Urban. So that's what I did. I stuck to my guns. That's what I got.
Work out this time, but I know you'll be back. It's great to have you here. Let's hear it for him.
Another West Coast angler on the way in next. He's from San Jose, California. How about it for Chris Zambe?
Tundra, courtesy tougher day to day. What seems to be status quo for our field. Two fish here today, 15-15 yesterday. To add to that here today, 5 pounds and 12 ounces. And gonna finish with 21 pounds, 11 ounces, but it's not over yet. You're sitting in 13th place and gonna keep your fingers crossed you stay in that top 25.
Absolutely, I felt like a fan today. I mean, all the way back to from the lake to here, I was on my phone looking at Bass Track, doing a little math. I think I'm gonna end up being the bubble boy, but to have an opportunity to go out there one more final day, I'm just hoping that I stay in the top 25 cut, get back out there and have a shot at a big bag. You know, I had a really good practice. Yesterday I started out with a bang, caught a 6-3 right off the bat, started in that same area and just caught these two little ones. And, you know, it's just like everyone else said on the stage, things changed, it got a little tougher today, and I couldn't make the right adjustments. So the only thing that I could ask for now is hopefully I make the cut, get back out there, and, you know, get to it with that 25-plus pound bag.
I'd love to see you back out there tomorrow. Let's hear it for Chris Selvain.
And let's keep it going here for our next angler coming in from Leeds, Alabama. Here's Aaron Martin.
Not one, not two, but a three-time Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year. Aaron Martin at 10 pounds and 10 ounces yesterday. And let's see what he's got to bring to the plate here today. Four fish for Aaron Martin, 10-10 yesterday. He needs 6 pounds and 7 ounces to currently get inside our cut for Championship Sunday. 6 pounds, 7 ounces to get inside our cut. 10 pounds and 5 ounces currently in our cut with 20 pounds, 15 ounces in 15th place. And you gotta hope to stay there till the end of this weigh-in.
Yeah, I want another chance. I tried to do something a little different like I talked about yesterday, just didn't pan out. Just, you know, a lot of us are fishing, you know, spots that we don't know we're fishing. So I haven't really, my best area, I've only pulled one fish out. I thought I pulled at least a 20 pound bag out of there. I caught one in there. I think somebody got in there. I know Ish was pulling out of there yesterday. Maybe he caught his fishing. I don't know, but I mean, Mark, when you get bit in practice and, you know, had a 7 pounder, a couple of flies, I can't, you work those areas a little harder and there's just nothing there. It's like, but you do hit one, they bite. So somebody probably caught them. That's part of the game. Yeah, I hope I have another chance. If not, you know, like, my family's here, and that's my big fan over there. My mom's here, my brother, his wife, my kids. Love you guys. I don't know. I stayed deep most of the day, but it seems like deeper I went, the smaller they got. I want to say that I got the new 921 Phoenix. I want to mention it. It's an awesome boat. Today, well, yesterday, I don't care what you're in, it's going to be rough, but today it was more just boat weights, and I was wide open all the way across. I made a last ditch effort to get some couple get a limit at least, and I ran about 25 miles the last couple hours, and that's phenomenal. And also, not to talk too long, but look for a new gummy onto the hook coming out. It's bad. It's awesome. I got some prototypes I've been using, and the keeper on it's incredible. But I haven't had a worm come down off the eye yet, so that's a really important thing. I just wish I could catch more fish on it. But just being here is awesome, and I'm really blessed, and I can't say enough about how exciting this tournament is. And you really want to perform for, you know, it's good for everybody to be up here but really, you know, you really do it for your family when you have kids and stuff. I know they pulled for me really hard, and, you know, they had tears when I got second, and I didn't. I was kind of bummed, but they were, you know, to see tears in their eyes, you want to win an extra badge for that reason, but they'll come up someday. My chances here are pretty much done, but we look forward to next year and excited to see where we're going next year, actually. And that's the most exciting thing, to see what venue we're going to.
I look forward to seeing you there. Keep on catching on the Elite Series, and you'll be right back.
All right, let's get some noise going here. How about some H-Town love here from Boulder City, Nevada? Well,